Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and you are welcome to All Souls Chapel of the Lashibi Funeral Homes. We are going to start the file past from the back. The ushers will direct us while the choir renders a few songs for us. Thank you.
Jesus, give me power to rule and reign. juwa ochina samana juwa ochina namuko owe asamana juwa nipa betimo amereko lusunuko yasi afanu apremo ogwezimoso adichinu mu wase anafani mu musu nini na etaye
Jesus in a room, in a wretched Namakuma, Semi for Jesus in a room, in a wretched Namedinija,
Semi
for Jesus in a room, in a wretched Namakuma. Jesus in a row, in your wretched name, in your need, your
Jesus,
Jesus, in a row, in your wretched name, in your need, Jesus in a room, in your wretched shape, no man you need your
own
need.
Me for Jesus, send me for Jesus in a room, in your wretched shape, no man could match me. Send me for Jesus in a room, in your wretched shape, no man you need your own.
Jesus in a room, in your wretched shape.
Suje, Dineho, Kaide Janayo,
Janayo,
Pasi Damano, Nakase, Jawira, Sera de Chiwa, Yafe, Nijesu, Nakase, Jawasi Deni, Nakase, Jawaye, Oyodo, Oyodo.
And cry aloud and give to God.
Rejoice again, I say. rejoice.
Rejoice, the Lord is King. Your Lord and King at all. Born to give us and save. And triumphs evermore. Lift up your hearts, lift up your voice. Rejoice again.
Permit me to say good morning, everyone. So thanks so much for your patience. Thanks for your waiting. We're just about blessing the remains of our dear mother and commending her soul to God's hands. After that, the casket will be closed and we'll have a very brief funeral service in her honor, and pray that God would look kindly upon her soul and grant her a place among the saints in heaven. During the closing of the casket, the management of this place will have the place cordoned off so we can close, and then we'll begin the service. Once again, welcome to this funeral service for the late Mrs. Lucy, na Adjele, Parker. Kindly join me here. May I invite us to stand, we bless the body of our dear mother. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the resurrection and the life, be with you all. I bless the body of Mrs. Lucy Na Adjele Parker with holy water, which recalls her baptism, of which St. Paul writes, "All of us who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death. By baptism into his death, we were buried together with him, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him by likeness to his death, we shall also be united with him by likeness to his resurrection. Lord God, source and author of life, you dwell in your holy temple, yet abides in our midst. In baptism, Lucy, now Adjele Parker, became your temple, and your spirit lived in her. With reverence, we bless her mortal body. May you accept and be pleased with the work she carried out on this earth, and mercifully grant a peaceful repose to her soul. In your eternal kingdom, we make our prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Kindly sit. So the management will now, as we so the very immediate family would stay on as the casket is being closed. Thank you.
Thank you.
My dear brothers and sisters, may I invite you to stand as we begin our service. The choir will lead us in singing the Catholic hymn number 328. Lead us, Heavenly Father, lead us.
Guide us, keep us, feed us, for we
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My dear family, whenever we gather in the name of our God, He is in our midst. He is the reason for our lives. He is the author of life. And it is only God who has the mandate to call us to Himself. It has pleased Him to gift the Parker and Saki families, our dear mother Lucy, in His own time, after 82 years of life, has called her to Himself. As we gather to spend these last moments with the remains of our mother, let us ask God to be merciful to her, to be merciful to us, that He would grant repose of soul to her, and also grant to us His forgiveness. Together we'll make our confessions. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May God Almighty have mercy on all of us. May He forgive our sins. May He bring us all to life everlasting. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, you willingly gave yourself up to death so that all might be saved and pass from death to life. We humbly ask you to comfort your servants in their grief and to receive our mother Lucy into the arms of your mercy. You alone are the Holy One. You are mercy itself. By dying, you unlocked the gates of life for those who believe in you. Forgive Lucy her sins and grant her a place of happiness, light, and peace in the kingdom of your glory, where you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Kindly sit. Our scripture reading is taken from John's Gospel, chapter 14, verse 1 to 6. Jesus said, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and take you to myself, so that where I am, there you also may be. And you know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know the way. We do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. However, a few words of reflection. It is just fair that I should, on behalf of the St. Peter's Catholic Church and the Holy Spirit Cathedral Church in Osu and Adabaka, respectively, bring to you our sincere condolences, especially to the family and to all of us mourners who gather around our mother this morning. I'll share a memory or two with our mother. I will draw some lessons for us from the scriptures. My first encounters with Grandma Lucy was just when we were recovering out of the COVID. And I remember very vividly how she had come to our premises at St. Peter's Catholic Church together with Mrs. Boulay. Their mission was very simple, that since she lives close by us, in fact, she's just a street away from the church, she would wish that we'd visit her as often as we can with Holy Communion, something she was entitled to, and something we do as custom for members of our church who have become frail and probably cannot go to church as often as they would do. And so she came. The practice has been that the pastor of the church, where the person usually goes, will be to speak to the priest closest to administer the sacraments to someone of the sort, as we find with Mrs. Parker. So it was quite interesting that she would come, you know, to say that, "Father, you know what, I'm entitled to this. So as much as possible, give to me what I am entitled to." I find the personality very interesting. Normally, they would have sent a family member or the other to come and make this request. But she came on her own, and I find her very assertive, you know, very interesting a personality. I mean, I was quite thrilled by how she could come forward. She came with Mrs. Bule, but she did all the talking, you know. Yeah. Those of you who know Grandma, she's very assertive, you know. She wouldn't allow you to have your way at all. So that was our first encounter. So naturally, our Eucharistic ministers would visit as often as we can. In fact, they make the calls to let them know when they are coming and all of that. The last meeting I had with her was in March. March, we had decided, my colleague goes as often as, but on that fateful Tuesday, we decided to share them among ourselves. So I had the opportunity of visiting her. And when we entered the house, I mean, she came to open and, you know, we spent some time with her. I realized she was alone. And she complained that, oh, the one who was with her had also left. So I asked, how are we going to make provision for some company for her? She said, the daughters have indicated they were going to come. So that was what comforted us, because for someone of her age and how frail she looked, one would expect that at least there's ready company with her. So when the daughter came, I got to know. She was admitted in the hospital for a while, but we visited and then she was also brought home. It is interesting that Mom, through all the time of ill health, didn't give up on herself, but to choose no other day but the day of the resurrection. For me, is the loudest message of her life. She passes into glory on a day when Christians all over the world celebrate the resurrection. One of the lines that is very profound to us Catholics in this time and very much drawn from scriptures is that through the death of Jesus, our own death to sin has been destroyed. And by the resurrection, our life has been restored in Christ. I don't think there's a better honor to our dear mother and for the life she lived for her to be honored this way. For the saints, especially the martyrs, their day of death is celebrated as their birthday into glory. So, my dear family, I am here this morning to remind us that while death may be painful because we lose our dear ones, it becomes an opportunity of entry into God's presence. Death becomes our exit from this life into God's presence to spend life eternally. And how beautiful, how reassuring that our mother's own happened on the day of the resurrection. I teased the family on Friday that Grandma is like Mary Magdalene, who runs to the tomb very early on the first day of the week, but never comes back home. She stays with the Lord. What does the scripture passage I've just read offer to us? My dear family, how can we come from God and not return to Him? How can we believe that we have come from God. He is the author of life. He gives us life. And how can we not return to him? And where would we have ended? What would have been our fate? And what would have been our destiny? So while we believe that what we are, what we have, the life within us, the breath within us, is God's gift. We have come from him. He has brought us here so that we'll make life eternally with him. So it was fitting then for Jesus to assure us that we should not be afraid. Our hearts should not be frightened. He goes ahead of us to prepare a place for us, so that where he, our head, is, the body, the church, the community of believers would also be. Because how can Christ save us and not allow us to spend life eternally with him? Because his resurrection is to remind us that while sin limited our life to this earth, by our being saved in him, who is the resurrection and the life, we are no more limited to life here on earth. We must spend life eternally with him. So my dear friends, my dear family, my dear parents, let us be mindful of the way we live our lives. Each day, you may want to ask yourself, where is my life leading me? Is it to those pleasant courts, those pleasant dwelling places where Jesus has promised us? Or it is to a faith that we ourselves do not know about? I have every conviction that Grandma Lucy, for that demonstration of faith on that faithful day, somebody who hungered and thirsted for Jesus to nourish her, if while on earth Christ could give himself to a mother to nourish her, how much more would he not readily welcome her into his presence? If Christ here on earth could give himself to us, how can he deny us heaven, where we would spend life eternally with him? So yes, moments like this can make us become frightened. Moments like this can make us doubt God's love for us. Moments like this can make us throw our hands in despair. But our joy should be that our mother lived well. She knew the Lord. She loved the Lord and served the Lord. Anytime we are asked at baptism, who created you? God created me. For what purpose? To know him, to love him, and to serve him. I think our mother met that criteria. May God be kind to her soul and grant her a place among the saints. And for we who have come to bid her goodbye, for we who have come to mourn, may our faith in Jesus our resurrection and life be strengthened. May God console us. Amen. May I now invite those to lead us in the prayer of the faithful to come forward as we ask God to look kindly upon us and hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the gift of life. Lord, our Heavenly Father, we thank you for the gift of life for the family of Mrs. Lucy Parker and all people here gathered. We implore you, O Lord, to sustain and preserve us. For this, we pray to the Lord. Let us pray for the soul of Mrs. Lucy Parker. Almighty God, we thank you for giving Mama Lucy to her family and the world. We are very grateful to you for granting her 82 solid years on earth. As you have called her out of this world, we pray that you grant her a merciful judgment so that she can rest in your bosom forever. For this, we pray to the Lord.
Let us pray for the bereaved family. Our Lord Jesus, we commit the bereaved family into your hands and pray that you wipe their tears and give them strength as they go through this difficult period. We pray that you will console them and be ever so near to them, especially the children and grandchildren. For this we pray to the Lord. Let us pray for the conversion of all people. Lord God, we bring before you all people who are yet to discover you. We pray that you will draw all of them to your saving grace. We continue to pray that all people will avail themselves to your grace and mercy. For this we pray to the Lord. Let us pray for the sick, poor, and needy. Lord, our Heavenly Father, we commit the sick into your hands and pray that you will grant them healing and strength to continue living for you. We also commit the poor and needy into your hands, that you will use us to alleviate their plight. Please bless them and grant them their heart's desires. For this we pray to the Lord.
We all are gathered here because we have had a time, a memory with our dear mother Lucy. Let us now quietly commend her soul in prayer to God and ask for his mercy upon her soul. Pray and add your private intention. We sum up our prayers and petitions and bring them to God our Father in the words of Jesus as we say together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. God, our Heavenly Father, you are the giver and author of every gift and blessing. We have called upon you in prayer to look mercifully upon the soul of our mother Lucy. We have prayed for ourselves, we have prayed for our loved ones, and all those who are dear to us. Comfort us in our grief, and may you strengthen us with faith. We make our prayer through Christ your Son, who is our Lord forever and ever. Amen. Kindly sit. We'll now take an offering to support the family. An offering to support the family. If we can have some ushers to direct us from the back as we take our offering.
Oh, kasama e
Ohu kasa
se wo kasa Ibe ye ya ba se wo kasa Ibe si ya ba kasama e ye kasama e ye
receive the vote of thanks and take some announcements from the family. May I invite the one responsible to take over. Thank you.
On behalf of our head of family, Nisaki Akumia the Sixth, Adansi Manche, and head of the Saki family, on behalf of the children, the entire Saki and Parker families and all the relatives, we want to say a big thank you to all of you for making time to mourn with us. It's been quite a short notice, but this is how our sister, our mother, our grandmother wanted it. So we want to say thank you so much. Father Lawe and Ma Service, since Friday, since the time she's been sick, we can't thank you enough. Thank you so much for all the time spent on with us as a family. We are most grateful. To Mr. Otu, Lashibi Funeral Home, and orchestrated by our own dear Auntie Esther. I mean, it's been quite a daunting task to get this, to pull this off. And we are so, so grateful to him. He's vanished. And to our dear niece and cousin, big cousin, Auntie Esther, thank you so much. We are grateful. To the choir, Antina, for us, we say Anna. Anna asked that, if anything at all, and she's laid down, we should sing for her. So it's so amazing that there was a little lateness, and you sang so wonderfully. Thank you so much. I'll get your number. Thank you. We are most, most, most grateful. And not the least, those who have helped us, the sites persons who have helped us. Have I left anybody? No. Who has helped us put things together. Thank you. Lashibi Funeral Home, you've been amazing. You've really, really helped us to put this, to pull this off. And to everybody here, everybody is as important to us. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I'll follow it with the announcement. From here, we'll have some refreshments out. We are not doing anything. We are following the wishes of our mother, grandmother, sister, family member to the letter. So from here, there will be packs of food outside, water. Kindly pick one. We are not having anything at the house. And then we want to carry her wishes to the letter. She gave us 1 week to do this funeral, and God being so good, we've worked within a week. So we thank you all for supporting us. When the clock crows tomorrow, thank you. Some people have come to ask, asking us to want to make a donation. We'll put it on the screen. There's a Momo number, 02054716 94. It comes in the name of Joe. Oh, sorry. Comes in the name of. Forgive me. That's how I call her. So, comes in the name of Nana Araba Gilbert Parker. So, if you want to make any donations, please 02054716 94. Thank you very much, and have a blessed Sunday. We also want to thank you all for your kind donation. Thank you very much.
I'm reminded that Grandma had a favorite song, "When the Trumpet of the Lord Shall Sound." She had a favorite psalm as well, Psalm 91. So before we say the commendation, the final commendation, I would ask the choir to lead us in singing "When the Trumpet of the Lord Shall Sound." When the roll is called up yonder, is that correct? Yes. And then one of the children will take the psalm, Psalm 91. Good. And then we shall have the final commendation. Thank you. The choir.
Let's hear the word of God from the book of Psalms and the favorite of our Antina, as we call. The title here is Assurance of God's Protection. Psalm 91. He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High, who abides in the shadow of the Almighty, will say to the Lord, my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. For he will deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with his pinions, and under his wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness is a shield and buckler. You will not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that stalks in darkness, nor the destruction that wastes at noontime. 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. You will only look with the eyes and see the recompense of the wicked. Because you have made the Lord your refuge, the Most High your habitation, no evil shall fall before you. No scourge come near your tent, for he will give his angels charge of you to guard, and in all your ways on your hands, they will bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. You will tread on the lion and the adder. The young lion and the serpent will trample under your foot. Because he cleaves to you in love, I will deliver him. I will protect him because he knows my name. When he calls me, I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will rescue him and honor him. With long life, I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. This is the end of the word.
May I now invite us for the final commendation. Let us stand. As we gather to commend our mother Lucy to God our Father and to commit her body to be cremated, let us express in prayer our common faith in the resurrection. As Jesus Christ was raised from the dead, so too are we called to follow him through death to the glory where God will be all in all. Our response shall be, Lord, have mercy. Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn Grandma Lucy and dry the tears of those who weep. We pray to the Lord. You wept at the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Lord Jesus, comfort us in our sorrow. We pray to the Lord. You raised the dead to life. Give our mother eternal life. We pray to the Lord. You promise paradise to the repentant thief. Bring our dear mother Lucy to the joys of heaven. We pray to the Lord. Our sister was washed in baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Give her fellowship with all your saints. We pray to the Lord. She was nourished with your body and blood. Grant her a place at a table in your heavenly kingdom. We pray to the Lord. Comfort us in our sorrow at the death of our dear mother Lucy. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. We pray to the Lord. Let us pray. Lord God, whose days are without end and whose mercies beyond counting, keep us mindful that life is short and the hour of death unknown. Let your Spirit guide our days on earth in the ways of holiness and justice, that we may serve you in union with the whole church, sure in faith, strong in hope, perfected in love, and when our earthly journey is ended, lead us rejoicing into your kingdom, where you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. We shall now extend our hands in farewell as the remains of our mother leave us. Grandma Lucy, may the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, to the new and eternal Jerusalem. Grandma Lucy, may the angels come to welcome you into paradise. May they lead you into God's presence. May you be taken to that holy city, to the new and eternal Jerusalem. May you rest in peace. May God console us who have gathered around your remains this day. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May the souls of all the faithful departed, especially the soul of Mrs. Lucy Na Adjele Parker, rest in peace. Amen. The Lord be with you. May the blessings of Almighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever and ever. Our funeral service is ended. Let us go in the peace of Christ. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thanks be to God. Hallelujah. The choir will lead us.